Oh, welcome to parts
18, I think. 17 or 18. I'll figure out post-edit. So we just found out Yukio's fine, so let's continue on with us.
Alright, let's meet up at Juness after school.
Every day's great and... Fuck! I hate that jingle. It gets stuck in your head and there's nothing you can do about it.
Okay, I think that's more than enough about my sorry escapades.
Right.
If I hadn't seen the place firsthand, I'd never have believed a story like that.
Huh.
Yeah, no kidding.
Hmm.
Anyways, we need to know what's going on inside.
Alright.
Well, how? By talking to that Teddy guy?
Well, yeah.
Yeah. Too bad there's so many customers around.
There's a cell in this department.
I got it. Come here a sec.
Okay.
Try sticking your hand in and calling him over. I bet that bear's wandering around the entrance anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Chia, stand over here. Make a wall with me.
All right.
A wall?
And a very pathetic wall, that is. You're trying to beckon Teddy over. Ah! Something bit me!
What's wrong?
I'm gonna smack him next time I see
him. You idiot! Dude, is that a bite mark? Are you okay?
I'm fine. I'll be alright. I think I'm gonna cry. I'll be alright.
Wow, that looks like it hurts. Sheesh, that stupid bear must have done it.
Yes.
Hey, you! We know you're in there.
Oh, is this a game?
You bit me. I'm gonna smack you.
No, it's not a game. Can you sense anyone inside there right now?
They could be taken so many ways.
This land feels so barren.
Oh, God. Oh, bad pun. Bad pun.
Shut it! So there's no one inside? You're sure?
I'm not lying. My nose is running as good as ever.
Right.
I'm gonna go warn Yukiko anyway.
Good idea.
Since she'll be busy this weekend helping out at the inn, I doubt she'd go anywhere alone, but
still. Good idea.
Yeah. You'll walk with her to school on Monday, right?
Sure. I'll go pick her up at her house.
Okay.
Maybe we'll find out more on tonight's Midnight Channel.
Yeah.
Cross your fingers that this is all just a misunderstanding.
Hopefully.
What's your cell number? I'll call you when I watch it tonight.
Alright. You exchange numbers with Yosuke.
Alright. Don't forget to watch tonight.
Alright. Was it really Yosuke who appeared in... Sorry, I'm laying down, so my pronunciation's all off. Yukiko, who appeared on the TV last night? Need to watch the Midnight Channel again tonight. Oh, look, Dojima-san.
Looks like we found all we're gonna find here.
Alright.
And we've still got nothing that points directly to a suspect.
Right.
We don't even know if this is a homicide.
Well, what else could it be? There's no way a body could end up like that by accident.
Yeah, he's got a point.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
We haven't found the cause of death for the first Vic. Now we got a second one just like it. If this is a murder case, there's no doubt we're dealing with a single perp. But if that's true...
You know, I thought at first this all spun out of that love triangle.
Hmm?
No. That singer, Misuzu Hiragi, has a solid alibi. She was performing overseas, and her phone records prove it.
Not the ticket sales or anything.
And remember, the only reason the scandal went public was because Hiragi herself broke it to the media. No one would put themselves under suspicion that way if they had a murder on their mind.
Got a point there.
Same with Taro Namatame, her husband. No matter how much we shake him down, nothing links him to the murders. He's been working in the city for the past 6 months.
Okay.
Seems he was here recently because of the scandal, but he was swamped with work back home at the time of the incident.
Oh.
There are eyewitnesses and other evidence placing him at his office the night that Mayumi Yamano died. And we can't find anything that shows Yamano making contact with Namatame before or after her disappearance.
You hear Namatame's career has also been killed stone dead? He's been fired from his position as secretary.
Oh, damn.
He's practically as much of a victim as the Yamano girl.
Yeah, I agree. Then we have the second case, regarding Saki Konishi. She's the one who discovered Yamano's corpse. I don't buy the killer shutting her up as a possible motive. She was killed well after she reported the body, and the culprit didn't hide her. It's like they were meant to be found. The only other connection is that she attended the same school as the daughter of the inn where Yamano was holed up.
Right.
But that hardly points to a motive. Coincidences like that are common in a town as small as ours.
Makes sense.
Yeah, I heard about that angle on the news, too.
What? Is the story about the inn out already?
Okay, I got it. How's this? Maybe there was something about the corpse that only Saki Konishi knew. And our perp killed her to keep whatever it was from leaking out.
Didn't you just say it's not about the corpse?
Either way, all we can do now is keep investigating anyone involved with the victims.
All right.
Our perp. It has to be someone in Inaba.
Oh, is your detective's intuition at work?
Angry Dojima. All right.
Welcome home.
Hey, thanks. Let's see what's in the fridge. Nothing catches your eye. All right, let's see. Oh, let's talk to her. This answer is really hard. Noko is absorbed in the... You should leave her alone. Fine, I'm going upstairs. Watch the TV in your room. Alright. It's raining tonight, and we're about that time again, so I'm going to have to call it short and say, until next time, see you on the flip side.